If you're a Twitch user or mod, let me guess, you've had trouble with Twitch trolls, scammy accounts, or just generally shady people coming into your channel. And before, there was really no easy way of dealing with this other than just banning people. However, Twitch has finally answered our prayers and give us a few more controls. With the brand new suspicious user controls, you can take more control over people coming into your channel that may be trying to take advantage of you, be a troll, or perhaps pump in links that you just don't want. And in this video right here, I'm gonna show you everything you need to know about it, so that way you can protect you, your channel, and your community. Here we go. Hey, what's going on, all you awesome streamers? Wild here to help you become bigger and better with everything on your streaming and content creations. Let's jump right into the video, and the first thing you're probably asking is, what the heck is suspicious user controls? Suspicious user controls are customizable tools to enable moderators and creators to detect, identify, monitor, and restrict chat privileges from suspicious users in their channel. The cool thing about this is mods can actually add users to monitor, or you can rely on the brand new Twitch AI to warn you of potential ban evaders. Now, when it comes to this brand new ban evasion detection AI, users will be put into two categories. There will be possible or likely channel ban evaders. By default, likely evaders will be put into restricted mode and possible evaders will be put into monitoring. So let's answer one of the big questions that you're probably asking. What is the difference between likely and possibly suspicious users? Now, coming from Twitch's own help page, their AI detection isn't perfect just yet and relies on a few key indicators. However, when they flag potential ban evaders as likely, it means that that user is much more likely to be a true ban evader and not a false positive. However, the machine learning is still not perfect. Creators and moderators have the ability to monitor or restrict these flag users or remove flags entirely. When someone's flagged as possibly, there could be false positives, which I'm gonna get into in another video. And if I've already made that video, you can check it out in the top right corner right over here. Okay, so let's just say you start one of your Twitch streams and you have one of these what may be a suspicious account, leave a message in your Twitch chat. Well, if they're a possible ban evader, they will automatically be monitored. Messages sent by a monitored account will appear in chat, but will be flagged in the chat panel for mods and creators to review. Mods and creators may monitor or unmonitor individuals as freely as they want, or you can rely on Twitch's default settings. When you have a user come into your account that is a likely ban evader, they will automatically be restricted. Messages sent by restricted accounts will be displayed only to the creator and their moderators, both in chat and in the mod view widget. Just like in the last one, you also have the ability to restrict and unrestrict the user in this mode. So how do you use this brand new ban evasion detection? Well, I've noticed by default, it's already active most likely in your Twitch channel. You just never really played around with it. If you want to make general changes to the settings, you first need to go to your creative dashboard, go to settings, moderation, then go to suspicious user controls. Here you will see ban evasion settings. From here, you can control the level of detection for likely or possible ban evader users. This level of detection will still allow moderators and creators to manually add or remove the flag on users who appear in your chat. Just a little personal note from me to you. If you're a brand new user on Twitch, that's a streamer, or perhaps you deal with a lot of, let's just say, trolls or just genuine dicks in your channel, I would probably leave this at the highest setting because it's actually easy to allow people to message if you want to, but trust me, it's gonna save you a lot of scammy messages coming in that you just don't have to deal with, so that way you can concentrate on the fluidness and streamline of your stream. Sure, that'll work. Now, Twitch already states that the AI detection is not perfect, which is why they allow you to add and remove people. Obviously, you add people that you know is gonna be troublesome for your channel, so you don't have to worry about it, which I recommend adding. But if you have someone that's a false positive, because that can happen because perhaps they got banned for the wrong reason or you misclicked on them, you can also remove users manually. This is actually a really dope tool, and I recommend you play around with the settings and see if you like what Twitch is trying to protect you with, because we've been asking for this for a long time, and the short little time that I've used it, I actually really enjoy it. Now, it doesn't currently work on any mobile device, and if you don't like it at all, the good news is you can turn it off. But I say give it a shot. This can be something that can really be a game changer if you get a lot of harassment or trolls in your channel. And if you need any more tips and tricks on how to be a better Twitch streamer, or perhaps to make your streams just better in general, or maybe even safe, you can take a look at the videos over to my side, where I'm always gonna make you bigger and better. I miss you guys already. Thank you for watching the video, and I'll check you all later. Take care, and of course, peace.